certainly be a spectacle. Now, there are few things we love moaning about more than the weather. But believe it or not, the Culture Secretary, Jeremy Hunt, thinks it could be a selling point.
Yeah, he says Britain's weather is much better than most people realise, and he's planning on marketing it to tourists from overseas. Do you think our infinite variety of snow, sunshine, rain and gales could be a draw then?
In a minute, we're going to speak to a branding expert to ask if we really can change people's opinions, and also to an American travel writer who's opted for our climate. But first, here's a reminder of some of our more memorable weather moments.
Bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man up on a fuzzy tree. A friend say I'm at just a bodily bug. I'm in love, my sugar.
And Britain's weather really boost tourism. Joining us now, branding expert Jonathan Goodbye and American travel journalist Jill Starley-Granger, who writes for the Sunday Times Travel Magazine. Good morning to
you. Good morning.
You like our British weather, don't you, Jill?
I love it so much. I moved here.
Not for the weather.
Not for the weather, but when I came here 15 years ago, I thought I was going to be coming to a country that was freezing cold and rainy all the time. And in fact, it rains far less than Atlanta, where I'm from in the deep south. And it's not nearly as cold as I expected.
It rains a lot, does it, in Atlanta?
It does, and the problem is when it starts raining, it rains for hours or days at a time, whereas here it's 5 minutes and you're done. Mm.
Can we turn this image problem round? Jeremy Hunt seems to think we can sell our weather because of the stats that we've just been showing on the screen.
Yes, but you see, there's stats, Bill, and there's stats. Okay. The fact I've got a set stats.
It's drier than Atlanta. There we go.
There's one caption. I can find places in the Amazon as well, which I suppose you could compare to if you wanted to. But it's ridiculous.
What have you got then?
Well, I've got, this is from World Climate. Okay, and they're saying here that during June, July, and August we have more rain than at any time apart from October. Now, you know, I'm just going by
not
by this.
Not more rain than anybody else.
No, I'm talking about in the UK, I'm talking about. Now, what people have, you're right, people have a perception that, you know, we have bad weather.
Yeah.
The stats kind of say that as well. And of all the things to promote in terms of our country, to for reasons for people to come here, to say that it's the weather is the number one thing, I think that's just ridiculous.
Well, Jill, I suppose other things are used to promote the UK, mm-hmm. but maybe what he's saying is that the weather is often seen as an off-putting thing.
Yeah.
Perhaps we can turn that round, but not as bad as you think doesn't seem a terribly good slogan.
Well, I think part of the problem
I'm
is
not saying that that's what he's suggesting.
People come to Britain for the history and the culture, but the coastline and the scenery is absolutely amazing. You know, we have a dramatic, amazing coastline, yet people don't necessarily get out there to that because they think the weather's so bad. Mm. Whereas with the branding, if they can get the message out that in fact, if the weather's bad, it will only be for a very short period of time, and in fact, it's not
maybe
as bad as you think.
The slogan should be, is not as bad as you think, because, for instance, if you go to America, great country, lots of people love to go, but on the East Coast, there are only two seasons when you can really spend any time for a long time out of doors, which are spring and autumn, because winter's deadly cold and sweltering in the summer.
Okay, but that's one country. There's a lot of other countries, okay? Now, there is an argument that that people would come here because they want to go on a city holiday if it's London, right? Or they certainly don't want to go to a beach in the sweltering heat. There is that argument.
Mm-hmm.
However, I still think that this is ridiculous, because unless they've got God on the board of their marketing department or whatever it might be, there's no way that you can actually totally predict what the weather's going to be. I mean, in fact, I will put out a call right now to anyone at home, and I will say to them, if you can tell me in 3 weeks' time exactly what the weather's going to be, I'll eat this weather climate.
Think of some slogans. How would you? I know you think it's utterly ludicrous and it's not going to work. Yeah. But as you're a branding expert, can you think of a slogan that, I mean, we've come up with a couple this morning.
It's not as bad as you think.
It's not as bad as you think.
It's drier than Atlanta. I mean, you know, is there, can we attract more tourists with an incredible chill?
You want to tell me which is very British, no?
Yeah, you know, what, okay.
I think the thing is, I can't come up with a slogan, sorry, off the top of my head, but to get the British countryside is so diverse and beautiful, and people will go to places like New England, they go to places like New Zealand where the weather is no better, and they go there for the countryside and the scenery. The branding can change people's perceptions and make them think, actually, British weather is fine.
There we go. So that, so we've got, we wouldn't have this countryside without this weather.
That's true, yes.
There we go.
There you go.
It'd be plain without the rain.
I like it. I'm giving you the deal.
Thank you very much.
You got it.
Well, what's your idea?
I was thinking about the idea of bring a British brolly, because you see there, you've got, you see in the background there, you've got the British brolly. You see, come rain or come shine, but probably a bit more come rain. Well,
see, I almost never have a brolly with me. When I came to this country, my mother gave me one of those shiny red raincoats. I never used it, because you just huddle in the doorway for 5 minutes. The rain passes and you're back out.
Leave the raincoat at home.
Exactly.
She beats Bill.
Nice one.
She beats Bill, because I think it should be huddling in a doorway, come to summer.
bring your lolly, not your brolly.
Bring your lolly, not your brolly.
This is it.
We're going to go into business.
Brilliant. If you've got suggestions, you know how to get in touch with us.
A slogan for people to come to Britain and as tourists that incorporates the weather.
Exactly.
That's it from this morning. Terrific.
That's a great start. Jill, Jonathan, thank you so much. 7:43. You're watching Breakfast from BBC News. Let's update you.